from time to time in the practice, you'll start to notice as you develop your mindfulness and concentration that the thoughts and emotions can become very strong, sometimes quite difficult to become mindful of, these thoughts and emotions. Often in the beginning, when we're practicing the first foundation of mindfulness, there'll be a lot of discursive thinking, just rubbish in the mind, trying to observe the rising and falling movement, for example, and the mind just wants to go out and think of all kinds of things. Well, that's part of the third foundation of mindfulness, citta nipassana. But in the practice itself, if we keep noting this discursive thinking mind, quite quickly it'll start to dissolve and not be a problem for you. But the emotional level, the moods of the mind, the mental states that can arise, wholesome and unwholesome, negative and positive, can arise, the conditions can arise for them to come to the forefront of the mind. And this third foundation of mindfulness is extremely important to notice and to watch, because it can get us into all kinds of trouble and create a lot of problems for us if we're not attending to them as they arise. And one of the attributes of mindfulness, the first I mentioned was remembering, just to come back to the present moment. But what I noticed with the cultivation of mindfulness is the quickness of the mind increasing. You actually can keep up with the mind itself. And you can see the beginning of a thought and emotion very quickly. And just through the bare attention of observation, it quickly also disappears, because things are arising and peaking and passing at a rapid rate. And the problem we often have is that we don't see this, and then we find ourselves getting caught up in them. But with the cultivation of mindfulness, and as the awareness becomes stronger, we're able to see it quite quickly. And in that, just the seeing of it, it doesn't have a hold over us so much. So, for example, even stronger emotions like anxieties, depressions, jealousies, things like this can be noticed. They're just thoughts in the mind that are coming and going. Just stronger thoughts in the mind. And this citta nipassana, or the watching of the mind itself, is a very important part of the practice, but difficult to get a hold of because its mind is moving so quickly. When you do notice these moods of the mind arising, it's extremely important to notice them. If you feel a little anxious, fearful, sad, that arises in the mind, where does it come from? It's come from craving, once again, in the mind. And so we need to watch them as quickly as we can, as quickly as we can. So if you feel anxious, for example, with this COVID-19, notice anxious, anxious. If you feel fearful, notice fearful, fearful. And see what happens. Watch its behavior and how it affects us. It's said that this mindfulness is just a bare attention, a non-identification, but an observation only of the experience. And noticing the arising, peaking and passing away of experience. So even if you need to watch a thought or an emotion for a little longer, sometimes if I'm feeling some mood in the mind, I'll just try to watch it. It may take some time for it to dissolve, but if you put your attention on it, you will see the dissolution of these emotions in the mind. It's really remarkable. So keep that as part of your practice as well. So we've moved through the body, observing the body, the activities of the body, the sensations, the feelings in the body, pleasant, unpleasant, and neutral. These need to be noticed. And then the third is to watch the thoughts and emotions if they become obvious to you. Now, Mahasi said in his instructions that we need to notice the most obvious object in the mind. We're going through it one by one at the moment, just to give you a reminder of these four foundations and how they are to be practiced. Of course, in everyday life and in our sitting practice as well, these things will come and go at different stages. Sometimes there'll be a lot of sensation in the body. You'll be aware of a lot of sensation. Sometimes the emotions will be quite strong. We don't try to control anything in Vipassana. We're just watching the flow, the movement of the mind. This is the key to it. And the continuity of this observation will eventually bring you to a more peaceful and understanding state of mind. So in this session, let's try and watch if it arises. It's not saying it will arise and we don't go looking for it. But if these emotions come into the mind, these moods come into the mind, please try to note them. We can do this by using the mental label. Mahasi advised that this is an excellent method for keeping the mind in the present moment, keeping our attention in the present moment. But over a period of time, when the mind is sharper, clearer, concentration's better, we won't need to use the labeling. We'll just be able to watch. Simple as that. But it takes time and perseverance and patience. Different qualities are required in meditation practice for the progression to happen. So let's try again. Once again, settle the body, keep it quite comfortable so you can sit for a period of time without shifting around. This is important also. We have to learn to face the dukkha and the sukha in meditation, as in life itself. Meditation is just a mirror of the life situation. Dukkha meaning the unpleasant, sukha meaning the pleasant. Try to sit quietly and watch. Be mindful. And remember when you're not mindful to come back to being mindful. So we'll have a short break now. I think Jess wants to talk about something, and then we'll 10 past or so, we'll have one more sitting, change the schedule a bit. All things change. And we'll do a sitting, for another half hour sitting. I'm really enjoying sitting. It's been quite a while since I've done something like this, a 4 hour sitting. It's great. I like it a lot. I hope you are also. Anyway, and it's pouring with rain. And the kookaburras, did you hear the kookaburras? Yeah. They were going off. Anyway, we'll be back in 10 minutes.